The first COVID vaccine for children above the age of 12 has been approved in India. This is the news at 10. And India's drug regulator has today approved Zydus Cadila's three-dose COVID-19 DNA vaccine for emergency use in adults and children aged 12 years and above, bringing in the sixth vaccine authorized for use in India. This makes this India's first COVID-19 vaccine to be available for this age group, that is 12 and above. The vaccine has many other firsts, but of course, this is the big focus because we have no other vaccine that is suitable for kids. Now, in other firsts, for one, it is based on DNA plasmid technology. Secondly, it will be administered using a needle-free injection system. And thirdly, it remains stable in room temperatures for 3 months. It's also a three-dose vaccine given on day 0, day 28 and day 56. The generic drug maker listed as Cadila Healthcare Limited applied for the authorization of Zycovid D on the 1st of July. This was based on an efficacy rate of 66.6% in a late stage trial of over 28,000 volunteers nationwide. Now, Zycovid is, or if it gets cleared, it will be the world's first plasmid DNA vaccine against the coronavirus, and it uses a section of genetic material from the virus that gives instructions as to either DNA or RNA to make the specific protein that the immune system recognizes and then responds to. So the Prime Minister Modi, of course, also tweeting on this because this really is the big story of the day. What does this mean for us? Could this be a game changer? Let's go across to Dr. Chandrakant Laheria. He is a public policy health systems epidemiologist. He works on epidemiology, I beg your pardon, vaccines. He's the co-author of Till We Win, India's Fight Against the COVID-19 Pandemic. We also have Dr. Rajiv Seth. He's a senior pediatrician and an expert on vaccines, the medical director of Child Health and Development Center, New Delhi, and the president-elect of the International Society for the Prevention of Child Abuse and Neglect. So, Dr. Laheria, first to you, Zycovid, the world's first plasmid DNA vaccine for human use. That's the big headline at this hour, and that really sounds, novel. The world's first plasmid DNA vaccine for human use. What is a DNA plasmid vaccine? If you could just explain it to us in layman's terms.
So, essentially, a plasmid DNA vaccine means the antigenic portion of the SARS-CoV-2 virus is picked up. So the portion of virus which can result in antibody formation in human beings is identified, and then a plasmid is a independent chromosomal particle is picked up, and that genetic antigenic sequence is merged with the plasmid and used as a vaccine. Once it's injected into human beings, it will result in production of antibody. Essentially, so the person will be protected when he or she is exposed to the natural SARS-CoV-2. So that's the approach. What we need to remember that on this approach or DNA-based platform, never ever a vaccine has been developed for human use in the past. So that way, this is really a big day for Indian vaccine industry, that India could produce vaccine on a platform on which no vaccine in the past for human use has been produced. It also is a very good news in the sense that while pandemic has been real challenge, but what we know that the vaccine research and development in this period has leapfrogged by at least a decade. And Indian vaccine industry has shown that when given a challenge, it can come up with some of the real solution. So I see this is a really a big achievement for the country.
It certainly is. So then, sir, that would lead one to ask, how safe are these vaccines, DNA-based vaccines? As you're saying, it's not been done before anywhere in the world on humans. So how safe are these genetic vaccines, and how tough is it to produce them?
So, well, what we need to remember that for the COVID-19 or SARS-CoV-2, there are mRNA-based vaccines, and now we have a DNA-based vaccine. Both are genetic vaccines or more or less similar platforms. However, DNA vaccines require one additional step, and that's why it takes slightly longer than mRNA-based vaccine. But they have an advantage, what people call plug-and-play technology, which essentially means that if there are some changes in the virus or there are new variants emerge, the appropriate antigenic portion can be identified and quickly modified. So they have a real good advantage of easy modification so we can produce vaccine. But it takes relatively longer time. And what we also need to be assured that since these vaccines have been tested through the clinical trial and found safe and efficacious, so nobody should be worried about the safety and efficacy part. So once we have a technology, we can appropriately utilize. So these are really useful. At the same time, what we also need to remember that considering there is far higher demand for vaccine in India than available supply, so it will be really shot in the arm for the country that we will have more vaccine availability. Yet we need to remember that considering vaccine has been licensed now, but it will go into production, so it will take few more months before vaccine will be available in the market and for the use.
Well, you've answered a crucial question. When will it be here? So you're saying 3 more months. It's also in a country where so far we've only vaccinated about 9.18% of our total population. So certainly this will be welcome. But Dr. Rajiv Seth, this is the news that parents across the country and pediatricians like you have been asking, when will we have a vaccine for children? Now, when you say this is a vaccine, a DNA vaccine, both for adults and for kids, your reaction when you hear this, and would you be part of that group that is vociferous to say that if and when this reaches the market in 3 months, it should be prioritized for children because it is the only vaccine that can be used on children?
Oh, absolutely. I'm indeed very excited about this. Children have been suffering, and we know that children have been off the schools. Their child development activities are at this thing. We are seeing so much mental health problems. Safety for children is extremely important. We have 440 million children, and obviously all will not qualify, but starting from 12 years to 18, this is a very good beginning, and certainly a welcome step. It's an indigenous-made DNA vaccine with Zydus Cadila, the Department of Biotechnology, and our own Translation Health Research Institutes and labs in Pune. So all of them have really come out with an excellent product, and we need to be proud of this. It has gone through its more than 28,000 volunteers have been studied.
The largest trial in India.
Its effectivity is about 67%, and it's something should be a game changer, particularly for children.
And it seems clinical trials in children above 5 years also on the cards. You're optimistic about that too?
Absolutely. For this, and also, as you know, the other vaccine made in India, Covaxin, is also being tried in age group from 2 years to 18 years. So this and other trials will certainly are very much needed. We know that children get a very mild disease. Majority, 70%, the first wave were asymptomatic. The second wave, we saw a lot more children in terms of morbidities and also moderate disease. There have been a high-risk condition in children, which is rare, but it is there where a person can go into shock. It's present like a Kawasaki disease, multisystemic inflammatory disease, and shock. So children need protection, and certainly I'm not saying that all children will suffer, but it's going to open avenues for their normal development. So I'm really very excited.
And hopefully this would mean that schools can then open up, because the big factor preventing schools from opening up is that there are no vaccines for kids. But Dr. Laheria, what is a needle-free injection system? An injection that is needle-free, could you explain that to us?
So
sounds like a dream come true, I must say, though.
Well, I want to answer this needle-free part, but I want to talk briefly about the vaccines in children.
Okay.
And I personally think that while it's a good idea, because these clinical trials were conducted in 12 to 17 years and vaccine is licensed for that age group. However, we need to separate the vaccine licensing and vaccination of children as a two separate entity. So while we have a vaccine which has been proven safe and efficacious in children, but whether it should be administered to children or not, that should be an independent decision by a technical expert group. We also need to remember that before opening of the schools, the vaccination is not a prerequisite. And the final part is that what we need to remember that many countries, for example, United Kingdom has licensed vaccine, which are sufficient quantity available, but still they have not started vaccination of children at 12 to 17 years. The key reason here we need to remember is that the currently licensed vaccine provide protection from moderate to severe illness and mortality. Now, as Dr. Sethi is also mentioning that moderate to severe illness and mortality is really low in the children. So the benefit of administering the licensed vaccine in children is relatively low. The benefit is far higher for adults. So adults should be vaccinated and it should be a slow process. So licensing should not be equated that parents start waiting for vaccination of children. I think it should be a considered scientific decision and there is still a long time.
Well, now, you know, this is a whole different debate, doctor, because this is what authorities and governments are saying. They're not opening schools because they don't have a vaccine for kids. While doctors like you are pointing out that kids may not necessarily need a vaccine because they may only be getting mild symptoms. But anyway, this is classic. This is what happens. The children of India are caught in this horrible conundrum where malls are open, liquor shops are open, parents are going out for dinner and, you know, swimming pools are open, but kids aren't able to go to school. But I want to just understand, again, what do you mean by an injection, a needle-free injection?
So essentially in this needle-free injection or jet injector technology, the vaccine quantity will be delivered into the skin or the arm of the person through a particular speed. So it will cross the skin and then reach the some particular section of the skin, and that's how it will be delivered. So no needle will be required, but a jet injector technology, which will be used to give administer the vaccine. That's what needle-free approach is. So needle will not be used.
All right, and Dr. Rajiv Seth, what about these new mutations, these new variants, mutant strains that we're talking about? Zydus saying that this vaccine is also able to take on, you know, the Delta strain, etc.
Right, that's what they say for now, and we will have to use it, and we'll have to see how the virus is going, and I'm sure there's a consortium which is well developed by now, and they're monitoring the situation, because these viruses will mutate. I mean, the more and more variants may come through, and therefore as we go along, the vaccination as well as modification, the vaccinations may be needed, but for now it is okay, it is safe, it's effective, and it should be given. Certainly our adults are the priority, but opening the doors to the prevention for children is also a very, very welcome step.
All right. So the big, big story of the day, India could soon get its first and indigenously developed vaccine for children starting now from 12 years onwards. Thank you so much, Dr. Seth, Dr. Leria, for joining us with your time and your perspective on the big story of the day.